Hello everyone, I'm Norman Warburger. In this one-off video, I want to tell you a little bit about my book, Divine Proportions, Rational Trigonometry to Universal Geometry. This is a good occasion because we are quickly approaching the 10-year anniversary of the publication of this book, which was 10 years ago, September 2005. So this book is published by my small publishing company called Wild Egg, which of course is based in Sydney, Australia. And in fact, this is the only book so far that we have published. I think it's a very novel book in many ways because, first of all, it lays out a new theory of trigonometry, a standard subject that high school students study, university students study, completely rational form of this subject. So circumventing the usual sines, cosines, and tans, and so on, replacing everything with purely rational insights, and extending the subject in lots of new directions, in particular to finite fields and to other metrical geometries, and really being the stepping stone to leading to universal geometry, which includes not just hyperbolic geometry, but major insights into other aspects of geometry. So I think it'll be a foundational piece, but it does take the mathematical community some time to kind of get around the idea that something so fundamental and, you know, elementary as trigonometry really can be redone right from scratch, and that the result can be demonstrably superior. So to celebrate the 10-year anniversary, I have decided to make this book freely available to the public in PDF form. So it is now a free download at ResearchGate. So ResearchGate is a very interesting, relatively new portal where people can sort of put their research out there and make it accessible and interact with other researchers, kind of like a Facebook for scientists and researchers. So I have a page there. You can see my publications, and in particular, if you go to the publication, this one here, you can download for free my book. So please do that. So I'd like to tell you a little bit about the book, okay? So it's a little bit innovative in a number of ways. First of all, it's just published by myself, so I did all the proofreading, layout, etc., etc. I arranged the actual publication of it and so on and so forth. So it was a kind of a little bit of a foray for me into the world of publishing, which was quite interesting. I also decided to lay it out in a somewhat novel way, so that you'll see that there are sort of gray areas, so theorems are marked in gray. There's lots of pictures, there's lots of theorems. I think most of the theorems are actually novel. And in fact, at the end, or near the end, there is somewhere a list of theorems. Yes, theorems with pages and important functions. And the theorems all have names. And there's 121 of them. Now, since the publication of this book, I have, of course, then gone on to start this YouTube series, and it was actually started by my series Wild Trig, which was an attempt to lay the foundations and describe some of the work in here. So the Wild Trig series I haven't actually contributed to for quite a while, but that's not to say that I not intent on carrying it on. So I will be returning to the Wild Trig series, where we're going to be going further into this book. And there's still lots of interesting stuff that I want to talk about and explain to you. So there are altogether, let's see, how many chapters do we have? 27 chapters. And the chapters are named, well, there's a, first of all, an overview, and then there's a background, and then there's a chapter on Cartesian coordinate geometry. We talk about reflections. And then the rational trigonometry section starts with chapters on quadrants, spread, then the triple spread formula, spread polynomials, oriented triangles and turns. Then I go to universal geometry. There's chapters on triangles, on laws of proportion, centers of triangles, isometries, regular stars and polygons, conics, geometry of circles, quadrilaterals, Euler line and nine-point circle, and tangent lines and tangent conics. And then on the part on applications, I talk about the triangle spread rules, two-dimensional problems, three-dimensional problems, physics applications, surveying, resection and Hansen's problems, platonic solids, and finally rational spherical coordinates, dealing with sort of calculus-type problems in higher dimensions. And notably, there's some appendices, one on rational polar equations of curves that deals with all kinds of classical curves from the point of view of rational coordinates. And finally, an appendix on the ellipson, which is a remarkable cubic surface that looks roughly like an inflated tetrahedron intimately connected with the triple spread formula. So at some point I will tell you all about that. It's a really fabulous thing. Okay, so actually at ResearchGate, if I get around to it, I'm going to try to make each of these individual chapters a separate unit, so you'll be able to download the chapters one at a time, a little bit more convenient for you than the whole big PDF. But currently you can get the whole big PDF at ResearchGate, and you can have a look at this thing, and it really is a door to understanding mathematics much more clearly. Because it's a fundamental topic, the basic formulation of geometry and how we set things up in the first place. And this book really shows that we can do things rationally and logically. Okay, so it will be a pivotal piece, I think, in the mathematics of the coming century. So I hope you'll have a look at it, and I do look forward to continuing on talking about rational trigonometry, which is still close to my heart, in this YouTube series. Thanks for watching.